Welcome to the TV and Film Review Podcast. I'm your host, Stuart Scott. Alongside me is Editor-in-Chief, David McGregor.
Hello, hello.
And our news editor, Liam Kearney.
Hello.
So, list of topics today. What do we have, David?
We've only got a few topics to discuss today. We're just going to have a quick run round of the table, see what TV we've all been watching this week, what's been good, what's been crap, and then we're going to touch on some news stories of the week, which Liam, I think, is going to take us through, and then we're going to finish off with some Oscar stuff.
Okay, good stuff.
So, with that in mind, I mean, do you want me to tell you what I've been watching this week?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, I had mainly sitcoms. Started off, at the start of the week, I've been watching Mom. I don't know if either of you have watched that yet.
No.
Have you seen it?
That's the thing with Anna Faris.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've not had a chance.
I saw the pilot and then that was it. Gave up after the pilot.
Yeah, do you know what? I thought it was going to be rubbish. And I absolutely hated Anna Faris at the start. You know, couldn't stand her. She was way over the top for me. Don't like her in Scary Movie or anything like that. But she's starting to grow on me. And do you know what? Do you know Allison Janney? She's been in loads of stuff. She's in that as well. And she's the one that kind of really steals the show. But I'm actually quite enjoying that. I have to say, for all the kind of sitcoms that I've watched, all the pilots, it's one of the better ones. And I think it's not been renewed yet for season two, but I wouldn't be surprised if it was. How are the ratings, Liam?
I think they're alright. I think they're probably just alright. I think because it's on CBS, obviously you've got stuff like The Big Bang Theory and all that, which is just like a monster. So I think comparing it, if you compare it to that, then it's not doing very well. But I think it's doing alright. You're right. I think it could come back. I think it probably more depends what CBS want to have like new next season more than anything else as to whether it comes back.
Yeah. Do you know, interestingly, I think it's actually probably got a better chance of coming back than the other CBS sitcom, the one with Robin Williams. The name skips me.
The crazy ones, yeah.
The crazy ones. Crazy times indeed.
It's bad when a show's out. Do you guys watch it?
Do you know, I watched the first three or four, gave up.
Yeah, well, like at the end, they show outtakes of the episodes, and it's bad when the outtakes from the episodes are funnier than the actual episodes.
That's right. I remember watching when I watched the first few episodes, that the outtakes at the end weren't actually the best part. I'm not sure what's happened to Sarah Michelle Gellar recently, but for me, she's turned into an actor. Buffy fans aren't going to like this, but I think she's struggling when she's doing the drama stuff, and I think she's struggling doing comedy. I don't know where she fits, really.
She's never really done anything good since Buffy, really, has she?
Yeah.
She kind of a bit of a one-trick pony. It's Melissa Joan Hart syndrome.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Clarissa explains all.
That's the one, aye.
Well, she wasn't quite one trick. She did
Sabrina the Teenage Witch. Yeah.
But still, since then, you know.
Yeah.
Time hasn't treated her well.
Yeah. Moving on from Mom, more sitcoms. I watched, there's a bunch of them on Tuesday that I've got round to. I've got rid of most of them. The two newer ones I'm watching, that have still caught me so far, is The Goldbergs and Trophy Wife. Both the Goldbergs is okay. It's been fine. This week it was fine again. It's very kind of 80s thing. I know there's a sitcom coming up in a couple of weeks' time. It's a 90s sitcom, Surviving Jack. What it is.
Yeah.
Very kind of similar lines, I think. I mean, I don't know how much if you've seen any of the Goldberg, but it's okay. It's nothing mind blowing. I think it should be fine.
I must admit, I think it's probably my favourite new comedy. I think it's great. Yeah. I think it's fantastic. But then
Who's your favourite character?
The mum. I don't know her name. I must admit, I don't really know any of their names apart from like the mum, the dad, and Barry. And I think he's the only guy. I think the mum. I think she's just hilarious. And like the episode this week's one where they're going to the dance and that.
That's right. I'm quite an 80s freak.
But I'm quite an 80s freak, so I think that's why I quite like it.
Yeah, do you know what? It wasn't bad, and it's a show that I'm happy to stick with. Mm. I think it's alright. For me, Trophy Wife, the other one that was on, to be honest, I really enjoy that. I think it's great, and it's probably my favourite new sitcom this year. It's, I mean, the kids steal the show. You've got a kind of, if you're not familiar with the premise, you've got a dad who's probably not the central character really, but he's got three wives. He's, you know, he's on his third one. He's got kids with them all, and it's just sort of interaction around the family. I haven't watched Modern Family, but I know I've heard some people compare it to it. You know, trying to sort of rip off that idea. But I, you know what, it's very funny, and the kids steal the show. I mean, there's three of them, and especially the two boys, they're brilliant, and it's a show I'll be gutted when it gets cancelled. And I say when, because the ratings are bloody awful.
Yeah.
Go for it.
Malin Ackerman.
Yeah. That's right.
I quite like her. Didn't realise she had a show this year.
Yeah, she, and do you know what? She's all right in it. She's pretty good. And it is actually quite funny, and it's had quite good critical acclaim actually. It's most people seem to think it's all right. It's just for people aren't watching it.
And I was going to say, I think the problem is, I think it's got kind of the Cougar Town syndrome, where people don't like. Well, I've read that people are thinking it's because it's called Trophy Wife, and people associate that with a, you know, kind of gold digging type thing or whatever. It doesn't have good connotations, so people have avoided it because it's cultural, which is ridiculous, but
yeah,
there you go. Whether that's true or not, I don't know.
And then the other one I've been sticking with on a Tuesday is Mindy Project.
I really like that this year. I think it's gotten so much better than it was the first season. It was good the first season.
Yeah, Stu, I remember, Stu, when we first saw the trailer. I remember watching the trailer for Mindy Project and thinking, this is going to be so bad, like really awful. And then I remember the pilot episode. I think it was you that reviewed it for the website, didn't you?
It was, aye.
And it was terrible.
Yeah, the pilot wasn't good, and I was really against it. I think was it the second episode that hooked me? Like the second week, and it just hooked me in, and yeah, I love it now.
Yeah,
it's one of my regulars.
It just got good, and do you know what I love even more? Have you noticed this season they've cancelled the most annoying theme tune in history? They've sort of slimmed it right down.
Oh, do you know, I've never even noticed.
Have you not? Oh, it was awful.
It's just the do 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 do.
That's what they've left in, but because before it was some sort of 30 seconds of extended. Oh, it was just hated it. So I'm glad they've got rid of that.
I quite like it. It's quite 90s. It's like a 90s ringtone on your Nokia 3310, isn't it?
The other sitcoms, I'll come back to Community. I'm sure that's probably on your list as well. The Neighbours was the other one I watched, and it's a show that I think I'm going to finish up with. It's not had a great season 2, I didn't think.
Yeah, you and Luis really liked it the first year.
Yeah, I loved it. I loved the first season. It was so weird, it never took itself seriously. It was, like the Mindy Project, it had a really rubbish pilot, and then it came on leaps and bounds. There were some really funny characters, some funny stories in the first season, but this year it's not really got to me, and there's I've got too much other stuff to watch, and it's one that I think, sadly, is going to go. The same, unfortunately, with Nashville.
Oh, really?
I started watching Nashville. I think I was maybe about 3 episodes behind. So I was catching up with Nashville this week. I mean, it's a good show. I do like it. But for me, if I was to list all the current shows I watch and that I'm trying to catch up on, Nashville, I'd have to say, was at the bottom. Yeah. Near the bottom, yeah. Anyway.
Yeah.
There's something about it that's not kind of pulling me in every week.
I don't like that they've seemed to, like... I mean, not that I wanted it to be, like, Glee or anything, but I think, like, the way they've cut out the songs... They don't seem to feature. It seems to be like they're more kind of go down the soap kind of route and having all these like big like dramas,
yeah,
and, you know, shootings and stuff like that, and all the kind of the music side of it just seems to have totally been dropped.
Yeah,
well, that's a shame because that was its big hook, wasn't it? Having the songs in at the same time.
Yeah, I thought especially in the first season, I thought, well, that was one of the main attractions. You know, it was good getting the songs in there, and the songs actually felt. You know, it wasn't like a musical sort of TV show like Glee. The songs actually felt like they fit into the story, and they really added something. Whereas this season, it's just, you know what? It's all right. It's not bad, but it's just, I think it's time for me to step out of that. And
it's just not cutting it with the rest of your schedule.
Yeah, which is now, you know, I've just picked up True Detective. I was watching that this week, 2 episodes into that with Woody Harrelson and Matthew McConaughey.
Oh, yeah, we were speaking about this last week, weren't we?
Yeah, Matthew... I mean,
I've still not had a shot of it yet.
Matthew McConaughey is brilliant. Really good in it. Yeah. I'll tell you another show I actually started watching, well, started watching season two this week was Mr. Selfridge with Jeremy Piven.
Yeah, it's on my Netflix list, actually. I just seen that season two was starting over here.
Yeah. I enjoyed season one. It, you know, it wasn't a great show, but it was one that, you know, I'd put it on my Sky box. Just for anyone listening out there, if you ever hear us referring to, you know, a Sky bot or Sky plusing something or anything, it's our version of what Americans call DVR, is that right?
Yeah. TiVo, is it not?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a box you record your TV shows on. So I had Mr. Selfridge recorded on, saw season two start and recorded it, and again, it's fine. It's a show that I'll probably won't watch all of season two. I'll probably get rid of it. Jeremy Piven's very good. The problem is I only care, I think, about two of the characters. The rest of the cast, it was one of those shows where, I mean, maybe it wasn't true, but they seem to have ditched almost everyone from season one and almost got a brand new cast for season two. It certainly felt that way when I was watching it. You know, I was like, there's all this influx of new characters. Which, you know, I'm sure some of them will turn out fine, but, you know, that was it. And as I said, the last show that I was watching was Community. I don't know if either of you have watched that this week.
I haven't seen this week's episode. Am I right in saying that that's Donald Glover's last?
Absolutely. Goodbye to Troy.
His last main episode, yeah.
Have you seen it, Liam?
I've never seen Community in my life.
I know.
I can tell you're all gonna gang up on me for it, but no, I've never seen it.
Yeah, in that case, I'll touch on it briefly. I mean, it was.
Well, I know that it was his last episode. I kind of.
Yeah, it was. He was. He's left the show now. It was his farewell. And to be honest, the episode itself, I didn't think was that great. It's had quite a good start. You know, we discussed this last week, I think. You know, the season started off quite well. I didn't think this episode was great, but it was passable. There was a lot of good material in this that should have made a good episode, but for some reason, I didn't think it was okay. I mean, you know, you've got the kind of emotional bits near the end and all that, which are fine. But, yeah, let me know what you think when you've watched it.
Yeah,
who wants to go next? What you been watching?
I guess I'll go next. I've not yet had my fix of Parenthood. That's my big one. One that I wait for every week. That's been really great this season, especially the second half of this season.
What season's it on now?
Five, just about to finish five.
Wow.
I don't think it's been good as four. I think four was an amazing.
Oh no, four
with the cancer storyline in it.
Oh, absolutely
amazing.
Brilliant.
But I think the first half's not been as. I think you see the second half now they've got rid of the silly mayor storyline. I think that was just ridiculous.
Well,
personally.
The only stuff that's kind of annoyed me this year is the stuff with Amber. It's not been like they were making him. What's his name? The guy from Friday Night Lights. Was it Ryan?
Yeah, Ryan.
But making him out to be like a great guy and all that, pure superhero at the start of the year, and then just get rid of him.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert, by the way. But yeah, that stuff wasn't really doing it for me, and it feels as if they've just been kind of contriving it to get to this point now. I'll see how this week's episode was. I'll give that a wee watch tonight, I think. What else? Oh, House of Lies, that was back last week.
Oh, is that back?
Oh. It's not been that good so far. This week's episode was good.
Yeah, big fail for me there. I thought you were talking about House of Cards.
Oh, well, House of Cards. Is that next week that's back?
That's Valentine's Day, House of Cards.
Oh, is it as late as that?
Yeah.
Even then, that's only, what, two, 3 weeks?
Yeah.
But no, House of Lies with Don Cheadle and...
Kristen Bell.
I was going to say Veronica Mars, but Kristen Bell, that's the one.
Yeah.
It's been a bit of a slow starter this year. It's another one's been a lot of change, and they've kind of split up the main cast, and it's not... I don't know if I like
it. Is the format still the same? I know, I watched the first season, you know, and it was... It was all kind of very slick with him talking to the camera and, you know, there was a whole bunch of stuff going on. And I thought it was all right, but he didn't do enough for me to get a second season watch.
There's not as much of that, the whole breaking the fourth wall thing this year. They kind of slowed down a little bit in season two as well. But it's more about the characters now than it is about like the business pitches and everything. Like it used to be all the kind of the drama surrounding them, you know, like the actual business. But now it's more about their lives and, yeah... I don't know. I still like it, but it's more for the characters than the story these days. I'm trying to think what else I've been watching. Oh, Justified. Justified's been back as well. Love it. It's so good. It's really underrated as well. It's another one you don't really hear much of here because it's heading away on
That's right.
US plus four or whatever.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. It's a show that's kind of... it's never really got much acclaim over here in the UK. I know it's certainly picked up since Netflix took it on.
Yeah, I think the first three or four seasons are on Netflix. Yeah. This season, it's just more of the same, really. It's so good. I love it.
It's a show that I really should have watched, because I love Timothy Oliphant. I think he's pretty good.
He's just so suave and cool, and it's like what I wanted Hawaii Five-O to be, the remake.
Yeah, did you still watch that?
Nah, I dropped it at season three, I'm afraid.
They got the little guy from Heroes in, didn't they?
Masioka.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah, but do you know, it's still a fine show. I could go back and watch it if it was on the TV. It's just too procedural. It's too much like CSI and all that. The only kind of thing in that style that I watch nowadays is Elementary, just because that's still a little bit different.
It's better than Sherlock.
I prefer it to Sherlock. It's a bit more really? Easy watching. I must be one of the only people that hates Benedict Cumberbatch.
Really
don't like him.
In anything? Nothing at all?
Nothing that I've seen him in, no.
Have you not seen The Hobbit? What about Smaug?
No, I've seen like half the first Hobbit and I didn't like it. And obviously, I wasn't in that. And I watched the first half of that about the WikiLeaks guy.
That's right. He's done a lot recently as well. I think I spoke to you last week and I touched on it earlier. I think Matthew McConaughey is probably one of those actors that have had a really, really great 12 months. But I think Benedict Cumberbatch is the other one. I think he's had a great year. He's been loads.
Yeah, he's had a lot of work. But
I watched him last week in August, Osage County. He's in that as well.
Is he in that as well? He has had a busy year.
He has. He's been in loads, and I think he's pretty decent. I've only watched the first season of Sherlock. I'm not up to date with it. But I think he's pretty good. I think he's going to be a name that sticks around for a while. Sorry, Stu.
Yeah, probably. I'm just not a fan. I think Johnny Lee Miller's much better.
I can feel the hate mail coming.
How do you feel about Justified ending? Because the next season's going to be its last one, isn't it?
Oh, I know. Next season is not going to be a good one for me. Because I think Boardwalk Empire finishes next year as well, doesn't it?
It does, yeah. And Mad Men, is that this year?
Oh, Mad Men 2. Oh, God.
Is that this year it finishes, yeah?
It could be, actually. Yeah, that's going to be the last season.
Yeah.
I'll need to find lots of new stuff to watch. One of the new things I picked up last week, Always Sunny in Philadelphia. I've heard non-stop about it on a few other podcasts that I listen to. And it is honestly the funniest show that I've ever watched.
Wow. It's just bold. That's a bold claim.
After that, it'd probably be Community, to be honest. There's nothing that I really laugh out loud to, but this just runs away with it by a mile. It's just so daft, and it's 9 years old, maybe.
Yeah, it's getting a big push through Netflix as well, isn't it?
Yeah, and that was one of my friends told me about it a little while ago as well and said I should watch it, and this is me just getting around to it. So I'll need to catch up with everything else as well.
Do you know what's strange, right? I think, you know, we're only 20 minutes in or whatever, and I feel like I've already mentioned Netflix, you know, two or three times. Guaranteed, if we'd done this maybe 2 years ago or something, Netflix wouldn't even get a mention.
Yeah, no, totally.
Probably not.
No,
you know?
Totally.
Such a big player now.
Yeah, they've done us a fair favour with the feature in November as well. Got a fair bit of traffic in.
That's right. If anyone wants to know what to watch on Netflix, check out our site, tvandfilmreview.com. It's on there.
We'll make a little link dump at the bottom of the article that this is going in. Link in all the reviews and things that we mention. Any videos, anything like that as well. Trailers or anything. Pretty much everything for me. Archer, been watching a little bit of that as well.
Is that good? I've always been to watch that.
It's quite good. I feel that because I've started watching at the same time as Always Sunny, it's just getting a bit underwhelmed for me. But it's worth picking up if you like that kind of thing. People keep telling me it's a bit like Bob's Burgers, but I hate Bob's Burgers.
Love Bob's Burgers.
Yeah, I think you'll like Archer then.
Okay.
It's that same kind of very dry humour.
Right, okay.
So what about you, Liam? What have you been watching this week?
This week, what have I been watching? The last three episodes of Sleepy Hollow, because the season finale of that aired this week. Because someone for the website reviewed it. Have you guys been watching it at all? Or?
Well, I watched the first episode. And do you know what? It was totally bizarre. It was really wacky, really over the top. I think John Cho, who I really like, was in it. And then I was gutted because he got his, I'm sure he got his head chopped off or something in the first episode. And I didn't really pick it up from there, but I've heard really good things.
It is good. It is. It, John Cho still pops up in and out of it, even though he did get killed, bumped off in the pilot.
Spoilers, Liam.
Spoilers.
Jeez, oh. He's not dead.
Well, he is dead, but he's... That's just how the weirdness of it.
He's still there.
Yeah.
Cat carries John Cho's head around with him. That's like his sidekick.
Oh, the ghost of John Cho. Yeah.
It's still a bit weird and a bit wacky, but it's... I think it's so bonkers, it's good, to be honest. And there's a few twists at the end, which I will mention for spoilers, which were good. And John Noble, who's, for Finch fans, Walter Bishop, he comes into it. He basically just plays Walter Bishop, to be honest. But he's really good in it. And I'm really looking forward to the second, because it's now got picked up for a second season already. So
it got picked up pretty early, didn't it?
It did, yeah. I think they, instead of giving it like a full first season, they've just given it, they've just kept the first season at 13 episodes and given it a new season instead. So.
Do you know, it's something that everyone that mentions it to me here, they all love it. I don't know if it's as big over in the States, but people here, they go mad for it.
Did you ever watch the original movie? There was one maybe about 10 years ago.
Yeah, that was the Tim Burton one, yeah.
Yeah, that must have been it.
That was good. I liked that. Who was it that was in that again?
Well, it must have been Johnny Depp if it was a Tim Burton movie, surely.
Oh, so it was. So it was. Surely.
Guys, it worked with anyone else.
Yeah, exactly.
Can I ask? Can I sidetrack here on your opinion on Johnny Depp? Because I don't know if I'm in the minority here, but I, you know, like you were saying earlier, Stu, with Benedict Cumberbatch, I mean, I really don't like Johnny Depp. Not so much I don't like Johnny Depp. I think, you know, he's a good actor and he's, you know, he's... I can appreciate that. But for some reason, I just don't like the films he's in. And I don't like his performances, and I've ended up really not liking Johnny Depp.
See, I don't like the Pirates of the Caribbean, all that kind of, all his kind of recent stuff, really.
Yeah.
The two ones that come to mind when I think of them that I really like, Sweeney Todd, the musical.
Yeah.
That he done. Loved that. I thought that was a great film. And going back to the '90s with Donnie Brasco.
Oh, that's what I was thinking. You know,
that's a great film.
I can pick out some, you know, Johnny Depp performances from a few years, you know, going back to the '90s and things like that. But I think I looked at his filmography recently, and I had to go really far back to find a Johnny Depp film that I'd watched and enjoyed. It just doesn't do it for me, yeah.
Right, I'm going to have to check it now that you've mentioned it.
Yeah. Sorry, while you're doing that, Liam, sorry, continue.
What else are we watching? Just to say, yeah, I agree with you, David. I'm not a great fan of Johnny Depp, and I don't like the Pirates of the Caribbean films either. But anyway, what else are we watching? The Fallen, that came back this week, so watched that earlier. That was good.
How's that getting on?
I don't know. I was one of these people that ended up just watching it because I hated it so much in the first season. It was just ridiculous.
Yeah.
And I ended up watching it just to say, this is ridiculous.
Speaking of people that you're fed up with, if you go to the cinema regular...
Oh, God. In
the UK, you will have a hatred for Kevin Bacon. Just to explain anyone listening who's not in the UK, we have the pleasure of every time you go to... cinema visit for a certain cinema chain. I suspect they're the biggest chain in the UK. So there's a good chance whenever you go and see a film, at the start of every single film, you know, after they've done all the adverts, you get Kevin Bacon promoting a new mobile phone, I don't know, product or plan or doing something silly. And if you're a regular cinema goer, it could just be fucking annoying. It's very tedious.
At least it's not the Conga adverts anymore.
Oh, well, that's
true. I suppose that's the bright side.
Yeah.
Those were bad.
Sorry, so the following is... I'm sure we can spoil the end of this. I watched the first season up until maybe... I gave up 3 or 4 episodes from the end. You know, I thought it was utterly ridiculous. I mean, what happened in the end of the first season?
Well, at the end, they found the cult. Joe Carroll, the serial killer guy, apparently got blown up in the end, so everyone thought he was dead. And
basically, let me guess, he's not.
No, spoiler, he's not. shock. There was a convenient trap door in the building that got blown up that he was in, so he got out. Pretty much everyone apart from Kevin Bacon and the guy who plays the Iceman in X-Men, whose name I can't remember, everyone else died. So it's pretty much just them. So now, in the second season, it kicks off a year later, and all of his followers are coming back, killing people again. So it was all right. Unfortunately, the character I really hate, Emma, she's still in it, so I don't know why she didn't get killed off. But yeah, no, it was all right. I mean, it wasn't as bad
Did they save the kid?
Yeah, the kid is now in witness protection, so he's not in anymore. But you know, the kid's alright. I don't think they could kill off a kid.
Yeah, probably.
So yes, it started off alright, but again, I thought the last season started off alright and then got ridiculous, so we'll see how it goes. And the only other thing I'll be watching, like, obviously I've been watching a few stuff that you guys have mentioned, like the Mindy Project and Goldbergs and stuff. The only other thing, probably Revenge. I doubt you guys will watch it, but...
Well, with Revenge, I didn't watch it when it first came on, and I remember getting, it was maybe halfway through season two, and someone had mentioned to me, you know, oh, you've got to watch Revenge. You know, season one is great, it loses it slightly in season two, you know, it's not as good, but, you know, season one of Revenge, brilliant, go and watch it.
Definitely.
So I think it was one of the shows that I first started watching on Netflix. Me and my girlfriend started ploughing through all the episodes. Thought it really had a really strong start, but then, I mean, you could tell it was a network show because, I mean, they were dragging it out for 20, you know, 22 or 24 episodes, however many it was.
Yeah.
Because by the end, you know, the first maybe 12, 13 episodes, really strong, really good stuff. And then by the end of the first season, there was just so much filler, so much utter rubbish that they were just throwing in there just to fill up time almost. And then when I got to the end of the first season, I was kind of like, well, you know, it was all right. It was decent enough. But then I'd heard such negative stuff about season two that I thought, you know what, I'm not even going to bother.
Yeah, well, I agree. First season was amazing. Second season wasn't great. I mean, I didn't think it was quite as bad as a lot of people were saying, but yeah, it wasn't as good. And I think the third season is, it's slowly getting back to the way to the first season again. But you're right, I think they kind of need to, I wouldn't say compare it to Lost as such, but I think they need to do a Lost and say, you know, we're ending this season or, you know, next season or whatever, and give it an ending, because they can't just, it's getting a bit, you know, how long can she kind of keep taking revenge on these people?
And they've got competition now, Liam. Betrayal.
Oh, yes, Betrayal.
Is that started? Is that this month?
Yeah, it started in September.
Oh, was that? Oh, of course, it was.
It's finished now, that's it. Had its 13 and done, so I don't think it'll be back.
Being gone, won't be back.
No. And now they've got...
I'm sure we missed out, yeah.
Yeah, I know, sounds like it. I don't know, I watched the first 20 minutes of it and had to give up. It was just...
What is your threshold? Do you have a sort of limit to how long you can go for a drama?
I don't know. No, I don't know. I can watch some utter rubbish, to be perfectly honest. And there's probably stuff I'm watching now that I'm not enjoying, and I can just keep watching it. Like Suburgatory is just got dreadful, but I'm sticking with it. But I don't know.
I suppose specifically for, you know, like a pilot episode. You know, so you're watching a pilot. You've never seen the show before. How long do you give it to get your attention?
I'd usually watch most of a pilot. I'll get through the pilot. It's only if I fall asleep. Like Betrayal, I fell asleep watching it, and True Detective, I know I should probably watch it.
You didn't like that.
I fell asleep during it. That's usually a sign that I'm probably not going to enjoy it, so I don't watch it. So if I fall asleep, I don't watch it. That's usually my threshold. What about you guys?
Yeah, I like you. If it's a, you know, if it's a sitcom, you know, it's got to be pretty bad I don't even get through the 20 minutes. But there's been a few of them. There's with the drama, I try and give it the full, you know, 40 minutes or hour, however long it is, and it's hard though. I mean, I know what you mean. Sometimes I watched one just 2 weeks ago, the one with Josh Holloway, Intelligence.
Got Intelligence, that's the one, yeah.
And I think I got maybe 15, 20 minutes in, and I knew it wasn't, you know, it was a show that I probably wasn't gonna like. So I decided to, you know, waste that time, you know, checking Twitter or something instead, something more productive. Have either of you seen that show?
No, but I'm really gutted that it's not doing well. I really wanted it to do well.
I like Josh
Holloway.
Because
I like the guys from it. Obviously Josh Holloway and... Sorry, I'm going to IMDb.
Yeah,
it's going on too much.
Well, while you're looking, I didn't. Yeah, no, I watched it, but like you, David, I thought by the end, I thought it's not for me. I'm not going to watch anymore. So yeah. I haven't watched it since.
Do you know, it's a shame because I like most of the Lost characters. Lost for me was one of, you know, love it or hate it, for me it was one of my, it probably is my most favorite show of all time. So I always have this thing where I'm always consistently looking out for people who are in Lost and seeing what other projects are picking up. And more often than not, I'm disappointed. I mean, you had John Locke. Oh, what's his name?
Terry O'Quinn.
Yes. Terry O'Quinn. I knew it was an old something, yeah.
It was Bo Young Lee that I was thinking of. And it turns out that he was only in one episode, so doesn't really matter.
Yeah, well. Right, where have we got to? Where did we sidetrack from?
Well, speaking of then, of say that you follow people from Lost going into other shows, like obviously Donald Glover's left Community, and he's getting his own comedy, I think it's on FX. Would you guys watch that because you like Community, or...?
I will watch it because I like Donald Glover.
I'm the same.
I watched one of his stand-up shows, and he is absolutely top class. He's such a good comedian, good at everything he does. I've got two of his albums in the house.
Is he not a bit of a rapper as well?
Yeah, two of his music albums, I mean, on my iPad, and they're good, you know. It's not just because of who he is, because he's in Community, you know.
What kind of rap is it, Stu? Is it sort of hardcore gangster rap?
No, it's like, it's hard to describe it. It's a little bit like self-deprecating, the way kind of Eminem used to be.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's well thought out, and it's not too kind of gangstery. It's not like dead auto-tuning like Lil Wayne and all that. It's good. You should give it a listen. In fact, there's a video for one of his latest tunes called Sweatpants. Sweatpants, yep. I think I put it on my Facebook. You should get a link on there. I'll put that in the link dump as well. And it's like Community outtakes. It's dubbed into the video. It's really good. There was another one as well, Freaks and Geeks, a while back. That was just as good.
Do you know that's a good TV show as well? Have you ever watched that? Freaks and Geeks.
No, it was a wee bit before my time, I think. What was that? 90?
Maybe early '90s, maybe.
Yeah.
I'm checking that for you just now.
But no, he's really good. I say stand up comedy and all that's pretty tough. You were talking about how long you guys give shows before you give up on them as well.
Yeah.
I have a 3-episode rule. If it's not good by 3 episodes, then I'm just giving up on it completely. It's got to be really bad for me to just pack it in altogether. The one that I've broken it for is Breaking Bad. Hated Breaking Bad up until about episode 5 or 6, when he blows up the guy's, whatever it is, his like wee apartment thing.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah, that was when it got good for me. Hated it up until that point. It was just too slow.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd go as far to say I hated it. I certainly didn't see the hype after I'd watched maybe the first 3 or 4 episodes, and I persevered with it. I knew it would probably turn good, and I'm glad I did. But there's very, very few shows that I actually do that with, and they tend to be ones that I know have been hyped up so much. Like I did that with The Wire. I remember watching The Wire the first, 2 or 3 episodes, not really getting it. Not understand what the hype was, and then sticking with it, and then it's one of my favourite shows of all time.
You know, I find that really hard to go back and watch. I never watched it the first time around, and people keep telling me watch it, it's better than Sopranos, everything.
Yeah.
But I think because it's so dated, it's really tough to identify with it, you know.
Yeah. Have you ever watched, speaking of shows dating, and dating well and badly, have you caught anything from the 80s recently, sitcom wise? Like for instance, I was watching Cheers the other day, and do you know what, it actually ages pretty well, but barroom jokes, it's all set around a bar, it's still pretty good actually. Obviously the sort of the technology's moved on now, you're watching it in standard definition and whatnot, but it's actually a pretty good watch and holds up quite well. Where I was also watching, I think it was on some obscure channel doing repeats, and I caught some of The Cosby Show. And that was my reaction after watching a bit of it. I was kind of,
yeah.
What happened?
God, that probably the oldest sitcom that I've watched is, I used to love Happy Days when I was at school.
That's right, yeah.
As soon as I got home from school, it was always on Sky One or something like that. They used to run reruns of it, and I loved it. I don't even know why I loved it. It's just, one of those things.
You wanted to be the Fonz?
No. See, I hated that character. I thought that was really. I never got it. It wasn't the thing. It was just, I don't know. I liked the show for some reason.
Do you know what, Stu? I hope they make a Happy Days movie, and I hope they cast Benedict Cumberbatch as the Fonz for your utter seethe.
I'm trying to think what other kind of TV news I've got. Oh, Grey's Anatomy comes back tonight.
Are
you excited for that?
No.
With April having to pick between Matt and Jackson.
What's that come back tonight?
Oh, Yep, tonight's on. Oh, no, wait a minute. No, I'm talking rubbish. 26th of February, isn't it?
That's weeks off, yeah.
That sounds more right.
God damn it. I was excited all day.
But you know what, that might be a seamless link, because that was one of my news things I was going to talk about.
Yeah, let's move on to news.
We could use that as a seamless link. Well done. So, one of the news things I was going to say was, obviously, that Ellen, is it Pompeo? I don't know, see her second.
Yeah.
And Patrick Dempsey, who's obviously Meredith and Derek and Grey's. You probably won't be interested in this, David. But anyway.
That's fine.
I've obviously signed...
You should be.
Yeah, you should be. I've obviously signed new deals to stay on for two more seasons of Grey's Anatomy. So, I don't know, Stu, what do you think? Are you quite happy with that? Because obviously Christina's leaving at the end of this season.
Yeah, that's the big thing. This is Sandra Oh's last season on the show, and she's one of the better characters. But she's gotten rubbish this year.
I think they're trying to destroy her character because she's leaving.
Maybe, yeah, that could be what it is. Just so people aren't bitter about it. But Ellen Pompeo, she's... Obviously, she's the title character and everything, but she's never really done it for me. I don't think she's the star of the show. She's not the best character. But Patrick Dempsey, he's the big one. He's like one of the everyone's favourite, you know? So it's good that he's staying on as well.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's good that he's...
Can I just check, Liam?
Yeah.
Did you say two more seasons?
Yeah, they've signed for two more seasons. Doesn't necessarily mean it's getting two more seasons, but...
I was going to say, how many seasons is it on?
10?
It feels like it's been on since...
I'm sure it's 10. Yeah, I'm sure it's season 10.
That's got to be one of the longest running.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. It's bordering on soap opera-ish, just with the amount of stuff that goes on at this hospital. Just make sure if you're holding in Seattle, just don't get hurt. Just make sure you've got your insurance covered.
How's the cast been on the show? I mean, obviously, you know, a show going on 10 seasons now. Has it had a big turnaround of...
Yeah, fairly so.
Has it kept its sort of core people?
Some of them.
Yeah, it's about, 5 or 6 of them have probably been there since the beginning. Probably.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think...
Sandra Oh, Patrick Dempsey, and Ellen Pompeo, and then...
Alex.
I forget the guy's name, Alex.
Yeah. Catherine Heigl's in that, isn't she?
She was
in it.
Oh, is she gone?
She's gone.
Too famous.
Surely it's long enough to be spoiled, but she kind of left in bad terms. I don't think she'll ever come back.
No. I think, yeah, she thought she was going to... Because that was when she was just hitting the movies. I think she thought she was going to be big. Not that she's not been big in movies, but I think she thought she was going to have this glittering career, and so she left.
Yeah, and she's just kind of floundered a bit, hasn't she?
Yeah.
But the guys that have been there from the start are really good. Some of the guys that have left were really good as well.
Yeah.
I quite like most of the new folks that are in. What's her name? The girl from... She was in Veronica Mars. She played Mark in it. She was one of the interns for this year, and I thought she was quite good.
Was she the one that got killed off at the start?
Yeah, that's the one. Also the guy from Friday Night Lights.
He's the only intern I don't like. I don't like him.
They've made him rubbish because of the Sandra Oh story.
Yeah.
It doesn't really... I feel bad for him because he was good before that, and I don't like the giraffe girl. She annoys me a little bit.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Who's suddenly...
I think that character's just awful.
Yeah, she's suddenly a lesbian and in love with...
Yeah, people change their sexual preferences far too often, actually.
Well...
I do like the English girl who isn't English in the show. Jo.
Oh, right. Is she? I didn't even know she was English.
She is, aye. And I only found this out because she plays Lara Croft in the newest Tomb Raider game.
Oh, right.
I thought that was pretty cool. Yeah, I quite like her. I hope she... There was rumours of her doing the Tomb Raider movie. Don't know if that'll happen, but I'd like to see her doing it. Her name escapes me just now, but...
I know what you mean.
She's very good anyway. What else do we have for the news?
Probably quite a big one is that Carrie Fisher, or Princess Leia, has confirmed that... Well, it's pretty much confirmed that her and Mark Hamill and Harrison Ford are going to be in the next new Star Wars movie, which is pretty...
That's very good news.
Right. Yeah.
I personally, as a big fan of the originals, I'm happy for that. I was kind of hoping they would have a minimal role. You know, I was hoping that they would be, you know, the story wouldn't be centered around them. You know, they'd be in it at the start. They'd probably come in to save the day at the end, you know, and all that sort of thing, because I'd be happy seeing them, you know, in a sort of olden role. I'm not so sure about, you know, certainly as the rumours suggest that the films are going to be based around them. I'm not sure how that sits with me.
Yeah.
But please see her back. I have to say, you know, and apologies if Carrie Fisher ends up listening to this, but she's looking a bit of a mess these days.
Well.
Have you seen her?
Let's not go into too much about her recent past. But,
yeah.
I heard she wanted the pretzel bun thing. No, cinnamon bun hairstyle back as well. Pretzel bun, Jesus Christ.
Pretzel bun.
Yeah, I don't know what I'm talking about. Just let's ignore that. But
who else has come from? Is coming back from the originals? Anyone else? Apart from the main three.
I think Mark Hamill was offered it. I don't know if he's going back for it though.
Well, I think she said that all three of them are, but neither of the other two have said, because she said that they're all going into filming in March and April, I think, but they've not confirmed. It's not been confirmed that they are, but she's said in an interview that all three of them are going back.
All right. So I thought it was just her and Harrison Ford.
I don't know. All three.
I don't know if I'd want to see any of the other ones back.
Not even R2-D2.
Oh, he'll be in it. They'll be in it. There's no way.
I don't know. Are they going to get the same guys to do them? Obviously not R2-D2, because he doesn't speak.
Jar Jar Binks?
Oh God.
Let's not go there.
Yeah.
I'd like to see Samuel L. Jackson back in it.
Didn't he die?
How are they going to do that?
I don't know. Never actually died. Just fell out a window. He's a Jedi.
That's true.
But are you not a bit afraid that having them for nostalgia effect is like a bit too kind of preachy, trying to appeal too much to the fans of the originals?
Yeah.
Would you not rather just start fresh with brand new characters?
Yeah, I get that view. I just think they've got such an audience for people who watch the originals that it would be foolish not to try and get them in some way. You know, I mean, it's certainly Mark Hamill and Carrie Fisher, you know, it's not as if they've gone on to become, you know, global stars, you know, and they're too busy for the project or anything like that, or going to cost too much money. Harrison Ford, possibly. But I think, you know, with the three of them, for fans of the original series, I think they have to bring them back. There'd be too much, especially if they came out and said, you know, we don't want them back. We're going a completely fresh direction. I think there'd be a bit of outrage. I think there'd be people that wouldn't like it.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, I agree.
I understand why they're doing it, but I don't know. I don't know if it's too sweet.
Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of them having their, you know, the film being based around them. I think it's gonna be too. I think it's almost gonna end up being like, what was that film, The Expendables? You know, with the sort of old, you know, when Stallone and Schwarzenegger and Bruce Willis and, you know, sort of this sort of old retired club coming back.
To be fair, first Expendables movie, pretty good.
Yeah, do you know what? Enjoyable, but it, you know, it's more of a comedy, isn't it? And they can't turn Star Wars into that.
I guess so.
I tell you what, I am quite looking forward to the new Star Wars TV series. It's
Are they doing that?
They are. It's an animated one, but it actually looks pretty good. There was it a trailer that was released this week, or there was some Star Wars news around it this week. I'm sure it was maybe some images or a trailer released for it. And do you know what? It actually looks pretty good. It's set between episodes 3 and 4.
Right.
And it's, I don't know if you ever watched the Clone Wars.
Not really.
I wasn't a huge fan either. I watched a few here and there, but this is going to be a proper, you know, full on drama. When I say drama, you know, it's an animated thing,
yeah.
But you know what I mean. It's not going to be a sort of kiddie, cartoon friendly version. Although in saying that, the channel that's picked it up and is producing it is Disney. The Disney Channel, so.
Well, it's Disney that made them.
Yeah.
So you wouldn't expect anything else.
And the only other news I was going to say was, I don't know if you guys, did you guys ever watch 24?
You know I do.
Well, I don't know if you saw Stephen Fry is going to be in the new series. He's going to be the
UK Prime Minister,
yeah. Which I think is going to be quite. I think it's going to be quite good.
That's pretty cool. I like that.
Do you know, I actually quite like Stephen Fry as an actor. He's in the second Hobbit movie as well. And he actually does quite a good turn.
Yeah, he's good on that.
He's not bad, and I'm happy to see him in 24. I don't know how the series is going to pan out. It's over 12 episodes, this one, isn't it?
Yeah. Apparently they're going to cut jump hours between episodes. So, yeah, like you say, I don't know how that's going to work, but.
Is Chloe coming back?
Yes, she's back. Her and, you've seen the pictures, her and Kiefer Sutherland have been filming in London. She's all looking like a goth now, like a big trench coat and everything.
Damn it, Chloe! I was never a huge fan of Chloe. She's a very kind of love-hate character, isn't she?
Yeah, yeah. But I think you couldn't have it back with not having her in it. I think like we're saying with Star Wars. You need to appeal to the original fans. I think she needed to do that.
What about Tony Almeida? Did he die in the end?
Did he not disband? I don't know. I can't remember.
I can't remember what happened to Tony. He was always my favourite. Do you remember the ridiculous way they brought him back after he died the first time? Spoilers, by the way.
Wasn't it?
After she was like 10 years old.
Yeah. If you've not seen it by now.
Spoilers now.
Well, his heart hadn't actually stopped or something random.
I mean, it was weird. He died, and was being written out the show, and it was a clear death, to the point where he's in the morgue. he was on the stretcher, the sheet over him, put into the morgue, the whole lot, because they'd intentionally, they were meaning to write the character out. He was dead, and then maybe two or three seasons later, they brought him back, and I can't even remember the ridiculous way that they did it. It was something like, oh, he wasn't quite dead in the end.
Yeah.
it was just surprise, Tony's back.
Fair enough, you can get off-screen deaths sometimes and they work out okay, but I don't know about an off-screen resurrection.
Yeah, it's almost, as we were touching on...
That's kind of a big thing.
Yeah.
That's got to be shown.
Well, yeah, it's like, we're talking with Star Wars, and Mace Windu, Samuel Jackson's character. You could almost, because you don't actually see him die, almost make up some sort of, half-arsed believable story that, some sort of speeder caught him in the air or something like that.
He's a Jedi, he can do whatever he wants.
Exactly.
He's Samuel Jackson, he can do whatever he wants.
Yeah, a bit of a false memory to kill him.
Yeah, Tony Almeida from 24 isn't a Jedi, and I don't think he can do resurrections, but he did. And I can't remember what happened to the character. I can't remember if he died or not in the end.
No, I can't remember either.
When's that back, Liam?
May.
Pretty soon.
Yeah, start of May, I think, so a couple of months yet. And that was it for the news.
Okay, on to the Oscars, which is the 2nd of March, I believe.
Yes, I think you're right.
And, I mean, are you guys staying up for it? Is that is award season in general? The Oscars, the Globes. Are they kind of things you're interested in? I mean, do you buy into them much in the results?
There's definitely a place for it. I personally don't really care. I like what I like, and it's not always the same thing. I know the stuff that I have liked from this year isn't going to win. They're going to go for something that they liked for different reasons.
Yeah. I mean, it's pretty much nailed on. It's going to be 12 Years a Slave or American Hustle for Best Picture.
Yeah.
I think it's guaranteed 12 Years a Slave. I don't think American Hustle's got a shot. But I think Wolf of Wall Street should have won, or should win.
I agree. It's one that out of all the ones nominated, Wolf of Wall Street was my favourite.
Which you can read my review on it. Just click at the bottom and like that.
Nice plug.
Yeah. Of course, but I was in absolute stitches for the whole film, and it's not. I can't think of another 3-hour film that can make
you do that. It's great, especially. I love the part. And this isn't spoilers as such, but you'll know the part I'm talking about, Stu, with the
Country Club.
When he's on the steps.
Yep, it's that's the Country Club scene.
Yeah, the steps of the car and all that sort of stuff.
I've never heard laughter like that in this year. It's just crazy. And if he doesn't win the best actor, at least I think it's shocking. I don't count for anything because that was amazing.
Has he won before DiCaprio? I don't think he has.
No, this will be his first. I think he should have won last year for Django, his supporting actor. I think he was nominated, but I think who got it last year?
I can't believe he's never won an award before.
No, I know, it's crazy, isn't it? I mean, Martin Scorsese never won anything for a long time. I think, was it Hugo that he won his first Oscar for?
Yeah, he certainly picked something up for Hugo, but I know Scorsese was a long time before he got anything, because there was all this talk about how he wasn't being recognised and all this, and but I'm surprised DiCaprio's never won an Oscar, not even in a supporting role.
I don't think so. It's like a big thing that he's never.
Yeah, wow, never that surprises me.
It is surprising.
Best supporting actor for last year. Christoph Waltz got it for Django.
Oh no, I think that's fair. I love Christoph Waltz in that.
I don't know. I think DiCaprio was better. I thought it was don't get me wrong, Christoph Waltz is brilliant, but
I think with the Oscars, the one thing that they do for me is they sometimes highlight, certainly in years gone by, they certainly highlight films that I wouldn't. They wouldn't have been on my radar otherwise. Not so much with the Best Picture category, Although there's been a couple. I know this year, Philomena is up for a number of nominations, including Best Picture.
Yeah.
That's one that at the cinema wasn't interested at all. But you know, due to the kind of the acclaim it's getting, I'll probably catch it. But certainly in other categories, I like the documentary category. Sometimes the foreign film ones. Not just in the Oscars, but for a lot of these awards show, there's sometimes the categories that highlight, you know, different features to me that ordinary would have, you know, passed me by, and I'll see something that'll kind of, you know, get me. I mean, certainly last year, I don't know if you ever heard of film Searching for Sugar Man.
Yes, I was talking to my hairdresser about it, believe it or not.
Wow.
It's about a South African folk singer from, like, back in the day. Is that right?
No, not quite. It's, I assume you've not seen the film then?
No, I haven't.
Right. I don't want to go into the film, because it is one of those stories that, you know, because it's based on a true story, if you go and look at it just now or look at it on Wikipedia, you know, it'll ruin it almost instantly.
Okay.
Just by, so even just, I would urge even not even to look at the back of the box if you pick it up on DVD or Blu-ray, because it's almost like you want to go in knowing, you know, as least as possible about it. And it ended up becoming my favourite film of the year in all categories last year. I thought it was phenomenal. Wow. Just a great story. I would highly recommend it. But make sure you watch it in good quality. No downloads here, people. Make sure, you know, you get it on Blu-ray, and have some good speakers, because needless to say, the soundtrack that goes along with it is great.
So, from your recommendation and my hairdresser's, I'll definitely pick it up.
Yeah, what's all that about, having your own hairdresser?
Oh, it's not like a private guy that comes to my house or anything. Like, works in the barbershop.
You see, you don't have a hairdresser then, David. Is that what you're telling us?
Well, no, I have a barber. I have a barber shop that I go to. Stu was talking about hairdresser, I thought you were talking about, you know, a full-on salon, you know, where they, you know, wash your hair and style it.
Aye, they do that, they're a good quality hairdresser. barber, whatever.
Oh, no, I'm still in the sort of, you know, Fiverr down at, I think it's a Turkish barber's I go to just down.
Oh,
down,
no, get that sorted, man. You've got to go full-on.
Really? How much is a haircut?
15 quid. Pretty reasonable, I think.
Well, that's not too bad. Fiverr for me.
I bet you don't get chat about Searching for Sugar Man, though.
Do you know, I don't. Do you know, I have the
barber... That's what you're paying for.
The barber I used to go to is actually... used to get a lot of good chat there. And he was famous for actually being the singing barber.
Oh, no, that's going to stop. I'd pay 15 quid for
a... Well, and this was only a fiver. This was only a fiver, Stu. And he was... you know, you'd go into this barber, and there was a few of them there, and this guy, he was the owner, and he also did, he did the haircuts himself, but he was the campus guy you could ever meet, and he used to blast on all his tunes.
Oh, please tell me it was Madonna.
Oh, there was everything. There was Madonna, there was It's Raining Men, you had all the classics. Do you know what? It was a great place, and you know, you always left there with a smile on your face. But the greatest thing was, I mean, I remember one time going in. I know we've gone way off track here.
Yeah, Head and Shoulders podcast brought to you by TVFilmReview.com.
Absolutely, we'll put a link to the barbers down below. they played. I'd gone in one Sunday morning, and it was pretty quiet for him anyway. And he started off Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen came on. And, it's just one of those songs that, you know, over the years, everyone sort of knows, regardless of generation. And he started singing along to that. And then two or three other people, you know, just punters getting their haircut, started joining in. And then, for sure, you know, the whole barbershop ended up joining in Bohemian Rhapsody. It was incredibly bizarre.
Did you have Muppets popping up in the background?
Yeah, that, do you know what? I would have topped it off. I like how you're trying to link this into film some way.
Nah. Let's stick with hairdressing.
Here's a question for you then. Name, what's your top film that has hairdresser or a hairdresser in it? On the spot.
Grease? Beauty school, hairdressing, it's the same thing, isn't it? No. Sweeney Todd. Just talking about it 10 minutes ago. Well, like half an hour ago now.
Is that about a hairdresser?
Yeah, he's a barber. Demon Barber of Fleet Street. Yeah.
I've never seen it.
Ah, you need to watch it, it's so good.
I don't know, Johnny Depp. bit of a wank. Yeah. What were you, Liam? Favorite hairdresser, film or TV moment?
Oh God.
Also favorite hairdresser in general.
Favorite hairdresser. There's too many to choose from. That would be a podcast in itself.
Do you get a lot of cup of tea at the hairdresser?
No.
Do you not?
I got offered tea or coffee. But then, to be honest, I'm paying more than 15 quid, so I wouldn't want to get offered tea.
Yeah, my girlfriend was telling me when she goes in to get her hair, she gets, she gets magazines and tea and coffee offered to her and all sorts. And I'm sure it's become a bit of a thing now where guys get whiskey. I'm sure I read that somewhere recently.
Oft?
Yeah.
Be half. Aye, back to the Oscars anyway. What I was going to say, I'm looking through the ones for last year, and it was Before Midnight. And just what you were talking about, never would have considered that film.
That's right, yeah.
Until I'd seen that, and it was absolutely top. I loved that film. And I went back and bought the first two as well. Still haven't watched them right enough, but they're pretty long, so I've got an excuse.
Yeah, Before Midnight, it's pretty good. I thought it was the weakest of the three. I think the first one is Before Sunset. Is that the first one?
Before Sunrise is the first
Before
one.
Before Sunrise. My apologies. That was my personal favourite, and then Sunset, and then Midnight. I mean, all three of them are great, and I just love the fact that there's 10 years between each film.
Yeah, it's what I like about it. It's very real. It feels like a genuine, like you're watching actual people,
yeah,
rather than watching a movie. It's pretty cool. You don't get that a lot.
And I love the way that when they filmed it, certainly over the all the films, they've. If you've noticed, they've got these really sort of long, long scenes with no cuts, and it's just great because you know that they've done that in sort of one take. I mean, sometimes you go 5-10 minutes and the camera has not moved or cut from, Ethan Hawke and Julie Delpy. So you know that they've just done all that all in a oneer, and it's just some great camera work and some great acting. Yeah, again, three films that I couldn't recommend high enough.
Yeah, very underrated. You never hear anyone mention them. And just general discussion, I
think Julie Delpy's very good. She's an actress that I remember after watching the Sunset, the second one, I thought she was going to go on to do lots of big things and lots of mainstream Hollywood actresses. I know she's done a lot in her own country, but I thought she'd do a lot more. But French actresses in general these days, there's a lot of them and a lot of really really talented ones that have came through over the last few years.
The girl from Inception and Dark Knight Rises.
Marianne Cotillard.
Yeah.
That's the one, yeah.
Yeah, she just came through. She's been brilliant. And Melanie Laurent as well from... She was in Inglourious Basterds.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And she's been in a few things recently. There's a whole bunch of them. French actresses that have come through the grade recently, and they've all been pretty good. And I think it's a really good thing for French cinema as well. I think it went through... I'm not claiming to be an expert in any way on French cinema here, by the way. but I think it's... I think for a long time it went through quite a barren spell, or a case where, it was producing good movies, but it wasn't perhaps getting any recognition.
Yeah, yeah.
I think the French film industry over the last, 4 or 5 years, it's really starting to grow. And I think over the next... 5-10 years, we're going to see a kind of real shift. I think we're already seeing that shift from American films to European ones.
Have you seen a film called The Class?
I haven't.
Is it Entre le Mur or something it's called? It's in French. But
was that your French accent there coming in?
No. That's the Entre correct pronunciation. But yeah, that is absolutely top. It won the Palme d'Or at Cannes a few years ago. A friend of mine told me about it, and it's amazing. Another one that just seems so real. What they done, it was just real school students.
Yeah.
And one actor, one professional actor, playing the teacher. I think he was also the director. And it's absolutely amazing. I'll send you a DVD copy in the mail. It's so good.
I like that, Stu. Using the mail. No.
Yes.
I don't.
None of this download pish.
Yeah.
What was the other thing I was going to say? Oh, French actor. Jean Dujardin, from The Artist.
From The Artist, yeah, that's right.
Popped up in, not American Hustle, Wolf of Wall Street. Didn't even realise until I was writing the review.
You're joking.
No, I knew the guy and I just couldn't place him. Right, and because they never had the moustache, I didn't recognise him.
Yeah.
He is superb in Wolf of Wall Street as well.
Yeah. Can I just say for the record, by the way, the artist, overrated.
Yeah, I wasn't keen. Another one we were talking about last week, and yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I as I said before, I liked how they tried to do something a bit different, and it was something I hadn't seen for a while, but overrated.
Yeah, it shouldn't have won that year.
Yeah. And on that note, I think we're just about done here.
Yeah, like I say, I'll put everything we've mentioned in the link dump just down at the bottom of the article, and we'll hopefully have this up on iTunes and most other places where you can get your regular podcasts.
We will, and remember and check us out on Facebook and Twitter, or check out the website, which is facebook.com/TV and Film Review, or we've got @TV and Film Review for those of you on Twitter. We also have a Google Plus, which I assume is TV and Film Review. and do you know what? Hit us up on our own Twitter account as well. I'm @DavidMcGregor84. Stu?
@TheStewDog.
Liam?
@Crisp_Packet.
What's that all about, by the way, Crisp Packet?
I don't even know. I don't know where it came from.
Any flavour in particular? Watsits, maybe? Quavers?
Is Watsits a flavour? Prawn cocktail, randomly.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
I don't know where it comes from.
And hopefully you can check us out on a podcast again next week and make this a regular thing.
Okay. See you later.
Bye.
And good. Bye-bye.
TVandfilmreview.com.